Dear freshman, my name is Will Fahey, and I don't want you to get your ass kicked. This is an open letter to freshmen, the goal of which is to keep you guys from getting your asses kicked. We're talking about high school freshmen because at this point in your life, you are the most disgusting that you ever will be. Until, of course, you reach the age of 60 when your body will start to decompose. Right now, your hormones are surging. We're gonna teach you about your body. Not really. This is an open letter intended to start a discussion, but also, for the most part, everything I say is right and don't disagree with it because I'm trying to help you. Let's open that letter. At this point in your life, you are more ugly than you ever will be. This is the ugliest point of your life, and there's no way that you can change that. But there is something you can do, and that's hide your appearance through clothing and makeup. Remember, nobody at this stage of your life will love you for who you are. The only way you're gonna get forward is by being attractive. Guys, don't wear a striped t-shirt. It's a lesson that you have to learn now. Striped t-shirts can only be worn by 40-year-old white men in Walmart, and it's not a flattering look. Another thing, there are only two times in your high school career where you can wear a tie. Prom, and when you're promoting something. Don't fucking wear a tie to your first day of school, or any day of school for the most part. You'll end up like this. This is me wearing a tie over a shirt that said, Street Life, with Sesame Street characters. This began the downward spiral of my freshman year. The sad part is that you can't see, but when the camera wasn't rolling, I was also wearing a Burger King crown. If you dress like an idiot, people will treat you as such. Don't wear Levi's, especially if you're white. Don't wear jeans, because you'll look like a school shooter. And everybody will tell you that you look like a school shooter. Just avoid that. The only reason you should wear jeans as a white high school student is if your high school offers a class in agriculture. But that doesn't happen too often, so just don't risk it. Remember, it's not your fault that you can't wear blue jeans. It's the fact that you're white, and you'll look fucking weird if you do. It's time to talk about the ladies. I don't know how to word this, but if you're a freshman, you're gonna get flirted with. By seniors, for the most part. Why?
Why?
Well, I like to think of it as the seniors who can't get seniors go for freshmen. But it might also be pedophilia. When it comes to doing your makeup, a little goes a long way. And a lot, you're gonna get bullied. The goal of high school is to get bullied as little as possible. Not bullied, because it's gonna happen, but just ease it off a little bit. If you have acne, then wear foundation, but if it gets to a point where you're getting called cake-faced, I'm really sorry, guys can be dicks, but start drinking more water. Clothing for girls is very simple, except that no matter what you wear, high schoolers will think you're hot as fuck. There isn't a single person that really cares about what you show. Dress codes, they don't mean anything. If there's a 14-year-old guy, chances are he's gonna get turned on, regardless of whether you're wearing a bun and a sweater, or if you're wearing a sundress. There's nothing you really can do, and that fucking sucks. Use those boys to your advantage. Get them to do things for you. Might as well make profit, you know? The handwriting is shit, but basically we're talking about self-care. High school is rough, and if you don't drink water, it's gonna be even more rough, and you're gonna look disgusting. All of high school, I didn't understand. I thought, hey, I'm just getting acne because genetics. It's just genetics, right? No, it's because the entirety of the school day, I wouldn't drink water. Drink water, exercise, go to sleep. You're never gonna get 8 hours of sleep. Just accept that now, it's not gonna happen. You're gonna have teachers telling you that you should get it. You're gonna have counselors telling you that's possible. It's not. If you get 8 hours of sleep, you're either gonna be suffering socially, or you're just gonna be doing really bad in school. This is another tip for the ladies. If it makes you feel pretty, or if it makes you feel nice, if it makes you feel powerful, do it. There's no reason not to. It goes for guys too. If there's anything that you can do to steal a little happiness for yourself, you're gonna need to do it, cause it's high school. Now we're gonna talk about something that's very dear to me. Notice it doesn't say bullshit. It doesn't say don't bullshit. It says no. When to bullshit, because if you don't, you're fucked. For example, I bullshitted a project in one night, and I ended up getting a B in my best class. Was that the right time to bullshit? No, it wasn't the right time to bullshit because the project was worth 30% of my grade. Let's say that you're taking a standardized test that doesn't affect you in school at all, it just affects the money that the district gets. Bullshit it. Because if you bullshit it, it's going to make the housing more affordable because they're going to think that the houses are by a shit school. Maybe don't bullshit it if you're selling your house at the moment, or if you have a strained relationship with your parents, do bullshit it. They're going to try real hard to get you to try. This test, like, you guys don't have to worry about it, but it'd be real nice if you guys did good. Don't do good. They're going to keep on having these shitty tests that make you really tired and they exert you. Until everybody just stops giving a shit. Once everybody stops giving a shit and everybody scores zero, the test becomes meaningless. We just need enough people to swear in apathy. If this video gets every freshman in the country and every single one of you bombs the test, there ain't gonna be a test no more. Remember to learn your teacher's grading and then exploit it. That might sound bad, right? Exploit my teacher's will? You mean like be a bad person? No, I mean like be a smart person. If there's a way to get ahead in high school, take it. Right now, your morals don't matter. Everything in high school doesn't really matter. Your entire life before high school, yeah, that didn't matter at all. Maybe you learned multiplication and long division. Good job, you're gonna use a calculator for the rest of your life. You fucked up. For the most part, things you learn in high school and college are gonna tell you that they're wrong. Get used to the idea that nothing you know matters, and you'll be a lot happier. If you can accept that nothing you know matters, then you're free. There are maybe 10 people in the world who became fluent in a world language through the high school system. You are not going to be one of those people. Foreign languages are dumb. If they weren't stupid, then we would all be learning Mandarin. We would be learning something infinitely more practical than learning French and Spanish. You guys don't need to learn this language that billions of people know. No, you don't need that at all. Hey guys. Who wants to learn French? If you take French class, you're pretentious. That's another thing. If you have an opportunity to take a world language that business is done in, take that. If you do love the language, be it Spanish, French, I think Polish is pretty useless, then by all means, learn it. It's never a bad thing to learn a language. It's just that there's languages where it's better to learn them than other languages. The final thing to do is to do something. Don't make your 4 years of high school about high school, otherwise you'll be depressed. Pick up a sport, a club, or an activity. Don't pick clubs that are just fan clubs. Actually, I changed my mind, you can join fan clubs. Just don't make them things that you'll get bullied for. That's another thing, I just don't want you kids to get bullied, it'd break my heart. You won't be Freshman Friday, that's not a thing if you go to a lame school like I went to. Your friends might do something funny to you, they might throw something at you. Ha, you've been Freshman Friday. I don't know what it's like at the more fun schools, but for the most part, Freshman Friday is just like a joke. Join a sport, if you can. The thing is that when you join a sport, you're gonna be with people who likely have some of the same classes as you. So when you're done with practice, you can say, oh, I'm so tired from practice. Did anyone on the team happen to finish the homework? They did. Now they give you the homework. Now you're good. Join group chats. Always join group chats. That's another way that you can get friends while having other people do your homework for you. Those are the two most important things in high school. If there's like some dance thing, or there's theater, and you don't really know if you can do it, just try out. There's like maybe 7 people on campus that are gonna make fun of you if you don't get in, and they're all shitheads, don't worry about them. A very quick way to ruin your high school experience is to make it just about education. If you just go to a building for 8 hours a day to learn things, and then you go home, and for 4 hours you do homework to learn things, and then you sleep for like 5 hours so that you can wake up to learn things, you're gonna wanna die. You need that little extra spice of life. Even if it's just playing video games at home, that's cool. Just don't be a nerd. I got nothing against nerds, but they may be a lot happier if they weren't just nerds. If you wanna just be successful, then by all means, be a nerd. But if you want to be happy, do something. Do something. That's all we really have to say today to help you guys out. Remember, I'm trying to start a conversation with the freshmen, or the people who were freshmen. But again, I went from this, I haven't really improved much since this, but I know what it's like to be a shitty freshman, and I'm here to help you. So I've given you tips. If you want to take those tips, that's up to you. Another thing that's up to you, that'd be really nice, is if you were to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I hope that you graduate and you're not just a 4.0 really, really sad person who got made fun of a lot, who gained weight because you're just stressing about grades constantly and you weren't caring about your health, that you kind of look good, like you're well presented. I hope all of those things for you. Have a nice day, everybody. And to the freshmen, have a nice school year.